敬的 Vaishnava 奉献者，今天是2021年7月20日，我们又荣幸地邀请到了圣 Bhakti Vedanta Vinashna Singha Swami Maharaj 给我们讲解今天的大伯加瓦坛早课，敬请聆听。 Hare Krishna。
Hare Krishna Om Jnanat Marandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chaksur Militan Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine。Namaste Sarasati Deve Kauravani Pracharine Nirvisesha Sunyavadi Paschacha Deshat Tarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Vaihevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha。Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare。 SoThe main part of the story of the Srimad Bhagavatam Rita is actually completed, and we're just hearing the conclusions being presented now.
大伯加瓦坛甘露这部书的主要的部分的内容都已经讲完了。
Yeah, and they want to, the Sanatana Goswami, the author, he wants to impress upon us the glory of Vrindavan and the special position of all the inhabitants of Vrindavan.
Sanatana Goswami， 他要强调的是文达文的荣耀以及文达文居民的特殊的地位。
So what we're hearing just now, we're going to hear several verses taken from the 10th canto Srimad Bhagavatam, which involve Lord Brahma's prayers to Krishna in Vrindavan.
现在我们将要聆听的是圣典伯加瓦坛当中的几个诗节，这个是主 Brahma 在 Vrindavan 向 Krishna 献上的祈祷。
And Lord Brahma, I remember he'd stolen away the cows and the cowherd boys, and Krishna had replaced them by his own expansions.
我们还记得主 Brahma牛犊和那些牧牛童，然后主 Krishna 就用他自己的扩展代替了所有的牛犊和牧牛童。
So first of all, Lord Brahma mentions about the greatness of the exalted position of the gopis and the cows, who all are serving Krishna as his mothers by giving him milk.
首先主 Brahma 就赞扬了勾匹牧牛姑娘和那些母牛他们的崇高地位，因为他们就像母亲一样为主 Krishna 提供了母乳和牛奶。
Right, the cowherd boys drink their mother's breast milk, and the cows drink the milk of their mother, the mother cow.
牧牛童朋友他们这些牧牛小牧牛童们，他们会喝饮自己母亲的乳汁，而那些牛犊们呢，则会吮吸他们的母牛妈妈的奶囊当中的奶汁。
So when Krishna was taking the place of all the cows and the cowherd boys, they were directly feeding their milk to Krishna.
So when Krishna, he directly replaced those cow and the cowherd boys, so Lord Krishna was in this way directly feeding those cow girls and those cow boys.
So this is the very great fortune. These ladies are very, very fortunate that they were able to do this service for Krishna.
So for them, this is a great fortune. They can do this directly for Krishna.
Because they are able to please Krishna by having Krishna drink their milk. So they are very, very fortunate.
他们能以这种方式让主 Krishna 喝饮他们奶汁, 所以他们就取悦了 Krishna, 因此他们是极为极为幸运的。
So the mothers are even more fortunate than the cows.
那些文达文的母亲们, 他们甚至比那些乳牛 更加幸运。
So Krishna is satisfied at every moment. Krishna is satisfied by drinking the milk of these ladies.
主 Krishna, 他因为喝了这些女士们的 乳汁, 所以主 Krishna 感到心满意足。
He's more satisfied by drinking the milk of these ladies than he is by a great Ashwamedha yagya which may be performed.
相比起马迹，对他做出的马迹来说， 主 Krishna 喝饮这些文达门女士的乳汁，他更加满意。
Even the great sages and demigods, they may be very expert in satisfying people, but they cannot fully satisfy Krishna.
伟大的圣哲们以及伟大的半神人们，他们特别擅长满足世人，但是他们却难以取悦主 Krishna.
So Krishna took the form of the calves, and he took the form of the cowherd boys, just so that he could drink the milk of these cows and ladies.
主 Krishna 他把自己代替了那些牛犊，并且把自己扩展为那些牧牛童朋友，目的仅仅就是为了喝饮那些母牛和那些温达文女士的乳汁。
But now, Brahma has come back, and so the time for Krishna to take the place of the cows and boys is already finished now. So the original cowherd boys and calves are going to come back and they're going to take their place, and it won't be Krishna anymore.
主 Krishna 代替了那些牛犊和牧牛童朋友的时间呢，也结束了。原本的那些牧牛童和那些牛犊们也都回来了，他们将要恢复他们的原来的地位。So
because Krishna has so much love for his devotees, he drank the milk of those cowherd ladies, and he drank it with great pleasure.
因为主 Krishna 对他的奉献者满怀爱意，所以他喝饮了那些女士们温达文牧牛姑娘的乳汁。And
when Krishna
只是为了给他们快乐。When
Krishna took the form of all these calves and the cowherd boys, Krishna still remained unlimited.
当主 Krishna 代替了那些牛犊，代替了那些男孩子们的时候，
because Krishna is the Supreme Absolute Truth, so he's unlimited.
因为 Krishna 是至高无上的绝对真理，因此他是无极无限的。
Even though he appears to be limited, like he appears in certain places, certain times, just to please his devotees, but Krishna, he appears to be limited, but actually he's unlimited.
虽然他表面上好像是有限的，他在特定的时间、特定的地点，他取悦了，他做了某些事情来取悦奉献者，但他仍然是无穷无尽的。
He can easily do whatever is normally impossible.
那些，他可以轻而易举地做到在常人眼中看来是不可能的事情。
So Brahma, he could, Lord Brahma is glorifying Krishna, but he could have glorified Krishna's devotee, Srimati Radharani, and he could have glorified the gopis, Radharani's companions, but he didn't do so. First, he's not yet understood the actual position of the gopis.
主 Brahma 他向主 Krishna 献上了祈祷，他本来是可以去荣耀 Srimati Radharani 以及荣耀那些 Gopis， 但是呢，他并没有这么去做，理由是他没有明白这些 Gopis 们的崇高地位。
Yeah, he doesn't understand how much devotion the gopis have the highest, the topmost devotion for Krishna. So that's not been understood, it's not clear to Brahma. So when he offers his prayers, he doesn't pray to be elevated to the standard, to the gopi standard of devotion.
因此，当主 Brahma 向主 Krishna 献上祈祷的时候，他并没有祈祷能够将自己提升到 gopi 们的崇高地位。
Brahma could see Krishna; he could only see Krishna as Balagopal, means as a child.
在 Brahma 眼里，主 Krishna 是 Balagopala 的，是一个小孩子的形象。
So when Brahma begins to offer his prayers to Krishna, he begins by describing Krishna as the son of a cowherd, the son of Nanda Maharaj, son of a cowherd, and he has small, tender feet.
所以，当主 Brahma 向主 Krishna 开始祈祷的时候，他首先形容 Krishna 是牧牛郎之子，他有着柔嫩的足。
He could have described Krishna as Gopinath. If he had understood about the position of the gopis, he could have described Krishna as the Lord of the gopis, but he didn't.
主 Brahma 本来是可以赞扬主 Krishna 是 Gopinath。是 Gopi 的主人，但是他没有这样去做。
And another reason also, you could say that although Brahma is Krishna's oldest servant, right? Brahma is the oldest servant because he's the first person in the universe, so he's the oldest servant of Krishna. But he still thinks of himself as the son of Krishna.So he doesn't want to interfere or get involved in Krishna's intimate relationships, his loving affairs with the gopis.
Brahma, 他的地位本来是 Krishna 的最古老的仆人，但是呢。Brahma 他宁愿把自己当成是主 Krishna 的儿子这样的身份，所以他就不想打扰 Krishna 的关系，不想打扰到 Krishna 的这个爱恋之情的这种关系。
Right, if your father's having a loving affair with a woman, You know, you don't want to get involved really in his, what he's doing with the lady, you know. He's your father, so you have to respect him and not get involved in his private affairs.
倘若说一个人他的父亲呢，他的父亲有了这种恋爱关系，那作为儿子呢，儿子就不想干扰到自己的父亲的私生活。
So Parikshit Maharaj is singing. He's describing these things. He's describing the mood of Lord Brahma. And remember, Lord Brahma is the spiritual master for all of us Vaishnavas.
Parikshit Maharaj, Brahma.
所以我们还要记住的是
Brahma， 他是所有Vaishnava的灵性导师。
So Parikshit Maharaj continues to offer prayers to, and he's describing. He says, Nanda Maharaj and the cowherd men and the people of Vrindavan are so fortunate.
Parikshit Maharaj， 他现在就继续祈祷道，在他的祈祷文中，他形容 Nanda Maharaj， 还有温达文的牧牛郎们，他们是如此的幸运。
They're very fortunate because the absolute truth, the supreme Brahman, and the source of all transcendental bliss has become their friend. So Krishna did this, he did this for the benefit of the people of Vrindavan. And he does this always, not just sometimes, but he always does things for the benefit of the people of Vrindavan. So he not only protects them from danger, but he also provides for them, he gives them the greatest ecstasy. So because he gives them so much happiness, they naturally think of him as their best friend.
因为主Krishna给他们带来了这么多的快乐，所以他们自然而然的就把Krishna当作自己最好的朋友了。
If they were to think of Krishna as God, then they wouldn't have so much love for him.
如果他们把Krishna视作是神的话，他们就不会对Krishna怀着这么多的爱。But
Krishna is actually the very best friend of all the people of Nanda Maharaj's cowherd village. So even though these people of Vrindavan are so fortunate that we cannot begin to conceive of their happiness. But at the same time, the 11 deities of the our different senses. Like in our body, we have different senses. So each of these senses has a deity. There's a deity for each of the senses. And they're headed by Lord Shiva. Because Lord Shiva is he's in charge of the ego. And the ego is the chief of all these senses. But we're also very fortunate.
我们的每一个感官都有一个神指在控制着这个感官。以Shiva是所有这些感官的控制者的领袖。那虽然就是我们就是有11个感官，他们的主要神指都控制着我们的感官，而且主Shiva是假我的控制者。
但是我们是如此的幸运。Yeah, when I say we, I mean we're talking about the senses, these deities of each of the senses, they're very fortunate.
当说到我们的时候，这指的是感官的这些神指控制神指，他们觉得就是这些感官的控制神指，他们自认为是特别幸运。
Yeah, because the senses of the devotees of Vrindavan, they're able to taste the nectar of devotional service. Because they're using their senses for the service of Krishna. So the deities of the senses, they also enjoy that pleasure. So in the material world, Lord Shiva is in charge of the every person's ego. Haribol? Gurnamala? Gurumani? Hare Krishna? Gurumani? Haribol? Krishna Kumari Nisaima.
Hare Krishna Guru. Ramani 掉线了，应该稍等一会儿，可能上来。好。掉线了。那边的气候怎么样？
You fang ma? This one is fang ma. We're in Mayapur. Guru Mani, Hare Krishna.
好的，稍等，我看见他好像上来了。Guru Mani， 你在吗？请举下手。Hare Krishna。
你回来了？快来！对，电脑突然就关机了。Sorry。Okay。 So we're describing about the senses, that Lord Shiva is in charge of the ego, and the moon god Chandra, he's in charge of the mind.
我们刚才谈到的是，就是这些感官的控制神智。主 Shiva掌管着自我，月神掌管着心意。So
there are 11 demigods who are very fortunate because they're in charge of the different senses, and they're able to enjoy the Brijbasi senses when they use their, because they're using their senses for the service of Krishna.
有十一个感官的主宰神指，当Vrijbasi他们在用自己的感官服务至尊主Krishna的时候，这些感官的主宰神指，他们也在享受着快乐。
Just like the Brijbasi people, they use their ego to think of themselves as servants of Krishna.
正如这些Vrijbasi，他们利用自己的自我来服务着主Krishna。
And they use their intelligence to make up their minds to act always for Krishna's pleasure.
他们运用自己的智慧来控制着感官，控制着心意，来总是服务着主Krishna。
And they use their eyes to see Krishna.
他们用自己的双眼去凝望Krishna。
And their ears to hear about the pastimes and the qualities of Krishna.
他们运用自己的双耳去聆听Krishna的
And they use their tongue to chant the glories of Krishna, to chant all his names. So the people of Vrindavan, they experience the nectar of service to Krishna.
就这样体验着对 Krishna 服务带来的甘露。
The people of Vrindavan, they can also be, it's also understood that they think of Krishna's lotus feet to be like a nectar. Even for people who are liberated from birth and death, they become intoxicated by the nectar of Krishna's lotus feet. So each of these demigods, they're in charge of one of the different senses. So they can serve Krishna by one of these methods of devotional service.
每一个控制着掌管着感官的半神人们，他们也是以这种方式在享受着父爱服务的甜美。
Right, the demigods, they make their life successful by offering, they offer themselves to Krishna.
半神人们，他们通过把自己供奉给Krishna，这样他们的生活便达到了成功。
And the people of Vrindavan, they use all their senses to serve Krishna in every way.
本达文的人们，他们以 各种各样的方式将自己的感官用来服务着主Krishna。
So these demigods, they take part in all the different activities, the sense activities of all the living entities in the universe.
这些半神人们，他们就参与着就是宇宙当中的所有的生物体的感官的活动。
But the pleasure they get from the people of Vrindavan, through the senses of the people of Vrindavan, is even greater than the pleasure they get from the senses of other devotees.
然而这些半神人们他们透过本达文达文的人们得到的快乐要高于他们透过其他的奉献者们获得的快乐比那些快乐要更高。
So the people of Vrindavan are so great, they're greater than all, even all or other devotees of Krishna.
So Vrindavan的居民们，他们比主Krishna，比其他的奉献者的地位要崇高。So
Brahma only mentions about 11 deities. But actually, there are more senses than that. Actually, there should be 13 deities, because. One explanation is, we could say, because he didn't want to include the organs like the anus and the genitals, because not so easy to use these. The demigods of these two senses, they do not enjoy the nectar of Krishna's lotus feet through these senses. Of course, they could use that. You could say they use the procreating organ to produce progeny, to produce children, but Brahma wants to avoid that. He doesn't want to be to discuss this thing. So, actually Lord Vishnu he's in charge, he's over all the demigods, and he's an incarnation of Lord Vasudev.
事实上主Vishnu他控制着所有的半世人，他是Vasudeva的扩展。
So not different from Krishna.
他和Krishna没有区别。
So we don't count him and we don't count Mitra. Mitra is the deity of the anus. So that way you get 11 deities.
所以就没有包括Mitra，Mitra是肛门的主宰神指。
At the same time, the people of Vrindavan have spiritual bodies, so their senses are not under the control of material demigods.
温达文的居民们，他们拥有灵性的感官，因此他们并不处在物质的半神的控制之下。
But the Brijbasi people, they imitate ordinary material people. They pretend like they're ordinary material people. And another explanation, we can say that the demigods, there are demigods from Vaikuntha. like Chandra and Surya, and they have spiritual bodies also, and they come to earth to take part in Krishna's pastimes in Vrindavan. So it's not wrong of Brahma to describe these demigods as being very fortunate to associate with the people of Vrindavan.
So, Lord Brahma, 这样形容这些半神人们来到地球上去参加这个消时光，他们何等幸运！Brahma这么说是没有错误的。And
we know that Lord Shiva and Lord Brahma also they both have spiritual bodies, so we can accept that other demigods also have spiritual bodies.
由于主 Brahma 他们是有着灵性的躯体的，所以其他的半神人们，他们也是有着灵性的躯体。And
we can understand that if the Brijbasi people make the Vaikuntha demigods fortunate, then we can understand what is the position of the Brijbasi people, that they're so great, they're greater than anybody.
如果 Brijbasi 他们这些文大文的居民，他们甚至把昆特的半神人们都变得幸运，那么可以想象一下，这些 Bridge Basi 他们的地位是何等的伟大。So
Lord Brahma says, it would be my greatest good fortune to take birth in this forest of Gokul, and to take the dust from the feet of all the people of Vrindavan, to take that dust on my head. So these people, we know these people of Vrindavan, that their life, their only thing in their life is Lord Krishna, and they take the dust. They also want to take the dust from the feet of Krishna.
We know Vrindavan the people, their life, their lives, their lives,
So Lord Brahma is praying. He said, if not in this life, then in another life, I want to take my birth where I can be one of your devotees.
Lord Brahma 祈祷道，如果此生不可能的话，那么我希望在某一世， 我能够投生为你的奉献者当中的其中一位。Even
if I have to take birth in the animal species, I it's as long as I can be engaged in devotional service, I don't mind.
即便我出生为动物的躯体，但是只要我能够从事于对你的奉爱服务，那么对我来说也无所谓。And
I could even take birth as a blade of grass in the forest, but that forest would have to be at the place where the cows and the cowherd people all live.
Lord Brahma 祈祷说，如果我能投生在那些母牛还有牧牛郎们他们生活的这个森林当中的，投生为一片草，对我来说。
So we may wonder, wouldn't it be better for Brahma to take a high position, to have a be a position like a ruler of the universe?
We
But Brahma says no, he doesn't want any, he doesn't want any position like that.
Brahma 回答说，不是这样的，他并不想取得任何这样统治者的地位。
He doesn't want to be born on a planet of his own. He just wants to be born on this planet, Earth.
他并不想投生在他自己的星球上，他想投生在这个地球上。
And he doesn't want to be born in a big city or a town. He wants to be born in the forest.
他也并不想 出生在大城市或者是繁荣的镇子，他想投生在森林。
And he doesn't want to just be with the yogis and the people who live in the forest doing austerities to make spiritual advancement. He doesn't want that. He just wants to be a cowherd in a cowherd village.
他也并不想投生在就是那些 苦行的瑜伽师们，在森林当中，去那里苦行，以获得灵性进步，投生在那样的森林。他想投生在这个牧牛郎和母牛的村子里。So
why would he want to give up his position, Brahmaloka, the top planet in the universe, to take birth in a village of cows like Gokul?
为什么 Brahma 想放弃他在 Brahma Loka 这样的最高的星球上的投生，而只是想投生在 Gokul 这样的牛牧牛郎的村庄呢
？Because he knows in Gokul he could get the dust from these people of Vrindavan who are all such great devotees.
因为他知道投生在 哭了，他就可以取得，伟大的奉献者，温达本这些伟大奉献者，他们的足下的尘土。
And that dust is better than all the water of all the holy places all over the universe.
这些尘土比宇宙当中的所有的圣水都要伟大。
Yeah, Gokula is the high, is the topmost of all the holy places.
Gokula 是所有圣地当中最崇高的圣地。
So Brahma prays that he can take. He says, Brahma thinks, what's the point to take birth as a creator? Better to be to get the dust of the feet of the people of Vrindavan.
Brahma is 这样祈祷，他也这样想。成为创造者有什么意义呢？还不如去取得就这些 Vrindavan 居民足下的尘土更好。
He said the Vedas have been trying to help us to find that dust.
他说，伟达经的目的是帮助我们去获得、取得这样的尘这些尘土。
But still today, they still have not found it.
但是至今为止，他们依然还没有找到。
They're not qualified to get the dust, because they still think of themselves in different material ways.
他们还没有资格取得这些尘土，因为他们仍然有个不同的物质的，以不同的物质的观念来思考。
And the Vedas just leave people in different ways in material life to improve their material life and to material success and ultimately to impersonal liberation.
伟达经它仍然在指导着人们，引导人们过物质的生活， 取得物质的成功，甚至取得非人格的解脱。
So Brahma is younger than the Vedas because the Vedas they teach Brahma.
达的年龄要比韦达经要年轻，因为他 Brahma 是取得了韦达经的指导。
So how can Brahma have any hope of getting the dust of the people of Vrindavan? If the Vedas can't get it, how can Brahma get it?
如果连韦达经都没有资格来取得文达文居民的尘土，那么 Brahma 又有什么指望呢？他就没有希望了。
So Lord Brahma points out that Krishna was very eager to appear on earth. When he appeared on earth, he was very beautiful, very attractive to everyone.
Brahma 指出，主 Krishna 非常渴望显现在地球。当他显现在地球的时候，他非常相貌俊美，他那么有魅力，他吸引了众生。
And he also called Lord Krishna is also known as Mukunda because he can give liberation, he can give the highest liberation, he can give the highest happiness of love of God.
To Krishna 有个名字叫 Mukunda， 就是解脱的赐予者。因为他可以赐予最高的解脱，他可以给人们赐予人们神爱的快乐。
And for the people of Vrindavan, Lord Krishna is always there in everything they do. Everything which happens in their life, Lord Krishna is present.
对于 Vrindavan 的居民们，无论他们做什么，无论他们生活当中发生什么事件， Krishna 都在那里。
So Lord Brahma is much younger than the Vedas, so he's like their disciple. So he's shy to even imagine that he could be a friend, he could be connected with Lord Krishna in Gokula.
因为 Brahma 的年龄要比韦达经要年轻，所以他是相当于韦达经的门徒。 Brahma 他就很害羞，他就很非常害羞，他不认为自己是 Krishna 的朋友，或者是跟 Krishna 任何联系。
So he thinks it's not possible to pray for something because it's just impossible for him.
所以他不认为自己可以祈祷到什么，他觉得这他来说这是不可能的事情。
Just like somebody may be very poor and very, very sick, so he cannot pray to become a king.
就像一个贫困交加，就身体有各种病的人，他都不可能祈祷能当上国王。
So that would be embarrassing for Brahma to also pray for something which is so far above him.
所以 Brahma 对 Brahma 来说，去祈祷能够得到一个远远高于他自己能够得到的地位，那是对他来说是很难为情的。
So Brahma says, my mind becomes bewildered just thinking about what reward I could get.
Brahma 就这样说道，当我想一想我能够得到什么样的回报的时候，我有这种念头的时候，我就不心意就感到困惑了。
The real benediction, the ultimate benediction is to get connected to Krishna.
终极的祝福是能够跟 Krishna 有连接。
But Krishna already gave himself, he already gave himself to Putana and her family members.
Krishna 已经把他自己给予了 Putana 和 Putana 的家人了。
Putana disguised herself like a devotee. So Krishna accepted her as a devotee.
Putana 佯装自己是个奉献者，所以 Krishna 就接受她为一位奉献者。
So what, there's nothing left to give the devotees of Vrindavan. They've given everything for Krishna.
对于 Vrindavan 的居民来说，他们自己已经不剩下什么了，因为他们已经把全部都给予了 Krishna.
So Lord Brahma, he's just amazed at the perfection, at the position of these people of Vrindavan, how they've given everything for Krishna.
Brahma 惊讶于 Vrindavan 居民他们的地位以及他们取得的完美，因为他们把一切都献给了主 Krishna.
And Krishna's very much, he's indebted to them because they've given everything to him.
因为他们把一切都交托给了 Krishna, 所以 Krishna 就感觉自己对他们有亏欠。
So Krishna himself is wondering, how can I repay them?
所以 Krishna 自己就想，我怎么才能回报他们呢？
So Krishna is all powerful, so somebody asks Krishna for something, he should be able to give it.
Krishna 是最有力量的人，倘若有人前来向他索取的话，他应该能有能力来给予他。
But Lord Brahma says, very difficult for him to repay the people of Vrindavan.
但是 Brahma 说道 ，Krishna 很难报答 Vrindavan 的人们。
Even if he was to give him his own self, he couldn't repay the people of Vrindavan.
即便 Krishna 把自己都给予他们，也无法来回报他们。
So Putana, you know, she was a demon and she took pleasure in killing little children.
Putana 是一个邪恶的女巫，她以杀死那些小婴儿为乐。
But she would disguise herself to look very nice, and she came into Krishna's home, and she wanted to kill Krishna.
但是 Putana 把自己乔装打扮成一个美丽的女人，来到 Krishna 家中，想要毒死 Krishna.
But Krishna took her as his mother, and he gave himself to her, just like he's her son.
但是 Krishna 却把 Putana 接受为母亲，并且把自己都交托了给他，就像儿子一样。
Krishna promised that he would give more to the people of Vrindavan.
Krishna 忍诺。他会给予 Vrindavan 的人们更多的事物。
So he gave himself to all the people and to the people of Vrindavan and all their relatives as well. But he did this for Putana also. So are these people of Vrindavan just like Putana?
Krishna 已经把一切都给予了 Vrindavan 的居民们。
No.
那么 Krishna 把自己交给了 Putana 呢？那难道
？Yeah. He gave himself to Putana, and he gave himself to Putana's brother, and his two Putana's two brothers, Baka and Aga. There was Bakasura, Agasura. They were they're the brothers of Putana. And so they're three demons, and Krishna liberated them. Yeah, Kamsa had sent them all the three of them, demons from the one family. They were friends of Kamsa, and Kamsa asked them to go to Vrindavan and kill all the children. So they tried to kill Krishna. Like Baka and Aga, because they were related to Putana, and because Putana had been taken by Krishna, so they also got Krishna's mercy. So Brahma says, if Krishna is going to give himself to the Brijbasis, then it's not enough.
Sorry, I didn't catch the meaning of the place.
If Brahma is saying that if Krishna is just going to give himself to the Brijbasi people, it's not going to be sufficient, because he already gave himself to the demons. So he's going to reward the people of Vrindavan the same way he rewarded the demons.
Brahma said, because Krishna has already given himself to these Brajabasi, so for him, this is not enough, because Krishna has already
But these people of Vrindavan, they surrendered everything to Krishna's service. They give their homes, they give their lives, everything for Krishna's service. So why should the people of Vrindavan just get the same position as these demons? No, the people of Vrindavan should get better than the people, these demons. Okay, so we will stop.
Krishna Kumari Balaji. 我这里看到第一个问题是有 Gita Sharma 的问题，对吗？ No， 因为我刚才掉线了，我现在手机上，先。
是的，是不是有 Gita Sharma？
哦，好的，第一个问题是。 Please accept my humble obeisance of glory to Srila Prabhupada and of glory to you, Gurudev, and the devotees of the Lord. In the spiritual world, all beings have pure consciousness, yet their ego is controlled by Lord Shiva. 第一个问题来自 Yogita Sharma, 请接受我卑微的礼拜，所有荣耀归顺帕帕的归民 Gurudev 和所有主的奉献者。在灵性世界，所有的生物都有纯粹的知觉，但是他们的自我是被主 Shiva 控制的吗？
Yes, Lord Shiva also has a transcendental spiritual body.
是的，主 Shiva 拥有一个超然的灵性的躯体身体。
And we were hearing today that there are demigods in Vaikuntha and they come to take part in Krishna's pastimes.
我们今天的课程当中听到在 Vaikuntha 的那些半神人们他们也来前来参加 Krishna 的消失。
So, not a problem.Lord Shiva, he is a great devotee.
主 Shiva 是伟大奉献主。
So he controls the ego. He controls the ego of the Brijbasi people also.
主 Shiva 他控制着自我，所以控制这些 Brijbasi 的自我。
But remember, the Brijbasi people, they use their ego to be the servant of Krishna.
但是要记住的一点就是 Brijbasi 的人们他们用他们的自我他们把他们自我当成是主 Krishna 的仆人。
So that is pure ego. That is not false ego.
这是纯粹的、纯真的自我，而不是假自我。
Yeah.
下一个问题 ，CCM， 顶拜古鲁，顶拜所有奉献者，主 Krishna 扩展出牛犊、牧牛童，代替被 Indra 偷走的牛犊，被 Indra 偷走的牛犊、牧牛童。问题是。主 Krishna 扩展出的牛犊和牧牛童有个体灵魂吗？同理，主扩展出的巴拉 Rama 和 Radharani 是个体灵魂吗？Obeisance to Guru and devotees, Lord Krishna expand himself as cowherd boys and those calves, replace those cowherd boys and calves.That have been stolen by Lord Indra. My question is that are those the calves and cowherd boys that have been expanded by Lord Krishna? Do they have individual soul?
They're all Krishna.
他们都是 Krishna.
They're not individual souls.They're not jivas. They are Bufan.
The Balarama and Radharani that has been expanded by Lord, are they also individual soul?
Yeah, well, Balarama, he is the expansion of Lord Krishna, but at the same time, he's not different from Krishna.
Balarama 是主 Krishna 的扩展，但是与此同时，他跟主 Krishna 没有区别。
And Radharani, she is the energy, the Shakti.The Ladini Shakti of Lord Krishna.
Radharani is 能量，是 Krishna 的 Ladini Shakti， 是 Krishna 的内在喜乐能量。
Yeah.
下一个问题 ，Yogita Sharma， The mind is said to be under Maya Devi, and the Munga is in charge of the sense mind. Mind, I am somewhat confused. Kindly explain, Gurudev. 接下来是有一个沙玛继续问，继续心意是处在Maya Devi 的控制之下，处在 Maya Devi 之下，而月神是掌管感官，掌管着心意，心意是月神掌管的。我有点困惑了，请仁慈的解释，对不对？
Can you read our question again?
The mind, it is said that the mind is under Maya Devi, and the Munga is in charge of the sense. The Munga is in charge of the mind. The mind is said to be under Maya Devi, and the Moon God is in charge of the sense, that is the mind.
All right.
I'm confused.
All right, so we said there are Vaikuntha demigods.
We said that
Right, so it means they're pure devotees. The moon god is not like the demigod, not like this Maya Devi. There's no Maya for the Brijbasi people.
对于文达文的居民 Brijbasi 来说没有玛雅，不存在假象。
There's only the service of Krishna, and everything they do is connected to Krishna.
对他们而言，只有服务，一切都是跟主 Krishna 有连接的。
So you have to give up your material thinking. You have to understand this is not.The material world, that these people of Vrindavan, the Brijbasi people, they're all pure devotees, they have spiritual bodies, and they're not under the control of material demigods.
So you have to leave the material thinking, material thoughts. You have to know that these are Vrindavan's people, these Brijbasi, they are pure devotees.他们拥有的是灵性的生命，他们不受物质半成人的控制。
Okay, go ahead.
下一个，雅穆纳想确认一下 ，Krishna 在宇宙中的存在是远远先于 Lord Shiva、Lord Vishnu 和 Lord Brahma 吗？谢谢 Guru 老师。So I want to confirm that if the existence of Lord Krishna in the universe is senior than Lord Shiva, Lord Brahma, Lord Vishnu, and Lord Brahma. Thank you.
Well, the whole universe comes from Lord Krishna.
It 是来自于主 Krishna, 从主 Krishna 那里流演出来的。
Before the creation, Krishna exists.
主 Krishna 是在早于创造之前，就是在创造发生之前，主 Krishna 已经存在着的。
And after everything is annihilated, Krishna will be there.
在一切。
Guru Mani? Hare Krishna, Guru Mani? Krishna Kumari.
Continue.
Okay. 对不起。 Where are we? I forget.
刚才您说到 主 Krishna 存在于 就是一切创造是 从主 Krishna 那里流演出来的 而在一切毁灭之后 主 Krishna 依然存在着。
Yeah, Krishna is the source of everything. Everything. Vishnu is the expansion of Krishna. Balaram is the expansion of Krishna.
Krishna
是万缘之
源，而 Vishnu 是主 Krishna 的扩展 ，Balarama 也是主 Krishna 的扩展。
Okay.
Okay. Krishna Kumar， 我的问题已经没有了，你能不能读一下？
好的，好的。安插他的瓦帕布，顶拜马哈拉杰翻译主持人和所有的奉献者。Krishna 明知道普坦纳要毒死他，还是接受了他的服务。那朵尤丹用大餐招待 Krishna， 但没有被接受。那朵尤丹和普坦纳有什么区别？
Oasis Guru Maharaj， Krishna。Putana want to give poison to Krishna and kill Krishna, and Duryodhan want to give Krishna a big feast, but Krishna accepted Putana, but Krishna didn't accept Duryodhan. So what's the difference between these two events?
Yeah.
Two people.
Well, Krishna has supreme independence.
Krishna, 他有至高无上的独立意志、独立性。
He can choose who he wants to be with him in the spiritual world.
Krishna 可以选择他希望谁和他一起待在灵性世界。
Remember, Putana, she came disguised as a devotee.
要记住 ，Krishna 把自己假扮成一个奉献者的模样。
So Krishna thought, oh, she wants to be a devotee. She wants to be with us.
所以 Krishna 就心想，哦，他想要做一个奉献者，他想要和我们在一起。
But Duryodhan, he was on the other side. He was fighting against Krishna.
可是 Duryodhan 他却站在主 Krishna 的对立面，就想跟主 Krishna 他们开战。
So there was quite a difference here. The mood of Duryodhan.Had not done anything. Duryodhan had been offensive to the Pandavas. They'd given a lot of trouble to the Pandavas.
They are different. Duryodhan, he had offended the Pandavas, gave them a lot of trouble.
They tried to kill the Pandavas.Several times.
他曾经 害死攀登公子。
So Krishna was not obliged to take service from them because they'd been so offensive to the devotees.
所以 Krishna 呢，他就并不，因为他们他独有胆他们冒犯了奉献者，所以 Krishna 不想也没有这个义务去接受他们的服务，去接受独有胆给他提供的大餐。
And Putana, of course, she'd also been offensive. She'd gone around killing little children.
Putana, 她也是有冒犯性的，因为她去那个杀死了很多小婴儿。
Yeah, before she came to the home of Nanda Maharaj, she'd visited many other homes and she'd killed many children.
在 Putana 女巫来到 Nanda 大君的家之前呢，他已经在别的人家就杀死了很多别人家的小婴儿。
But she did not kill the children of devotees. She killed the children of the demons.
但是 Putana 呢，他杀害的不是奉献者家中的小婴儿，他杀死的是那些恶魔家中的小婴儿。
So that's the difference.
所以这是普达纳和独有胆的区别。
Yes.
下一个问题。
你看一下我发的那个，它是前面错过了一个问题，英文的。
哦。前面有个问题是晕了 ，Dear Guru， 那在哪里呢？晕了，晕了的问题我这里没有。哦 ，Hare Krishna， 晕了有一个问题，刚才错过了，不好意思，对不起。Guru Maharaj，Hare Krishna，please accept my humble obeisances. Materialistic psychologists believe that anger is a more aggressive.Emotion then disappear. Does Vedic philosophy say anything about this?
Anger is it's more aggressive. What?
More progressive emotion.
Then
disappear.
Then disappear.
Yeah. Yes.
No, it doesn't make sense. Are you sure? Disappear.
E-E-S-P-A-I-R disappear.
More aggressive anger is more progressive emotion.
Yes.
And then
materialistic psychologists believe that anger is a more progressive emotion. Then disappear.
So,
does Vedic philosophy say anything about this?
Translate.
这个来自于呢 ，Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj， 请接受我卑微的顶拜。物质主义的心理学家们，他们相信，愤怒是比绝望。愤怒比绝望的情绪更高更好，就是应该是比绝望这个情绪要更高级一些。伟达的哲学对此有什么说法？
Well, what does the Bhagavad Gita say about anger? The Bhagavad Gita says there are three gates to hell.Lust, anger, and greed.
那我们看一下佛家梵歌是怎么说的。佛家梵歌说有三个通向地狱的大门：色欲、愤怒、贪婪。
And the anger comes from lust.
愤怒，愤 愤怒源于色欲。
Second chapter of the Bhagavad Gita describes different stages of spiritual fall down.
《维加梵歌》的第二章就描述了灵性堕落的不同的这个阶段。
When we think about sense gratification, we become attached to the objects of the senses.
心思感官对象就会对感官对象产生依恋。
And then lust develops.
接下来就会产生色欲。
And then from lust comes anger.
从色欲生出愤怒。
And then from anger comes delusion.
从愤怒生出幻象。
And then we become bewildered.
接下来的呢，当一个人陷入幻觉当中，他就会困惑。
And then we lose all of our intelligence.
当人困惑之后，就会失去一切的智慧、智性。
And we fall down again into the material pool of life.
当智性一失，一个人就会堕落到物质的生存的漩涡当。
So anger is something which is very dangerous for our spiritual advancement.
对于我们的灵性进步来说，愤怒这种情绪很有危害性。
At the same time, anger can be used in the service of Krishna.
但是与此同时，也可以，我们也可以将愤怒这种情绪转化成对 Krishna 的服务。
So somebody, if one has control over his mind and senses, then he may use anger in the service of Krishna.
就当一个人他已经控制了自己的感官，并且控制了自己的心意之后，他就可以运用愤怒来服务 Krishna.
Just like Arjuna used his anger to fight in the battle of Kurukshetra.
就像阿朱纳就把自己的愤怒用在了库鲁切特战役当中。
And Hanuman, the monkey, he fought for Lord Rama. He was also angry, fighting against Ravana.So that is proper use of anger, using it in the service of Krishna.
So this is the proper use of anger, using it in the service of Krishna.
And Prabhupada would sometimes use his anger to challenge atheistic and impersonal philosophies and speculations.
Atheist and impersonal philosopher 来挑战那些非人格的哲学家和非人格主义者。
Yeah, and speculators.
啊，挑战那些非人格的这些推敲思辨家们。
Yeah, so.That is using anger in the service of Krishna.
这就是愤怒，怎么把愤怒用来服务 Krishna 的例子。
But the anger should be carefully controlled. It must be properly controlled. It should not just be some emotional display.
是得到了控制，并且是恰如其分的运用愤怒，而不是一种情绪的展现。
You must be on the transcendental platform. You have to have understood you're not the body, and then you can properly use anger in the service of Krishna.
一个人应当处在超然的层面上，他知道自己不是个躯体，所以他可以把这个愤怒用来服务 Krishna。
If you use your anger, if you get angry at your children sometimes and you beat them, that's not proper use of anger.
如果你自己对孩子生气，有时候就是气得打孩子，这不是对那个愤怒的正确的用法。
Or sometimes you have an anger and you have an angry fight with your husband and you get angry and fight with him and yell and scream. This is not proper use of anger.
或者有时候跟自己的丈夫生气，然后对着丈夫又喊又叫，这个并不是对愤怒的正确用法。
That is anger controlled by the modes of nature.
这种情况是被物质自然属性控制下的愤怒之情。
So proper use of anger is to use it in the service of Krishna.
对愤怒的正确用法是将愤怒用来服务 Krishna。
So we understand anger in that way.
我们是这样理解的。Yuna said that disappear equals to desperation and hopelessness.
Oh, desperation. And I wondered what she meant. Okay,
yes.
Desperation and hopelessness. Now, despair, it should be made.
Despair.
Yeah.
Yeah.Sorry.
Okay. So, so then anger, what? The cycle, so read it again, the question?
The question that materialistic psychologists believe that anger is a more progressive emotion than hopelessness.
Than hopelessness, yeah.
So she wonder what does the Vedic philosophy say about this? What is the Vedic saying about this?
Well,
about anger and hopelessness.
Both of these emotions are on the bodily platform.
这两种情绪都处在躯体的层面上。
Anger is the frustration because you're not getting your sense gratification.
当一个人的感官享乐受到挫折了，他就会产生愤怒。
Your material desires are not being satisfied.
他的物质欲望没有得到满足。
And despair and hopelessness is the feeling that life has no meaning.
而那个绝望和无助以及没有绝望，它就是觉得生命没有活着没有意思，没有意义。
So both of these emotions are material.One is concerned with enjoying the material world, and the other is rejecting the material world. It's like karma and jnana. The desire to enjoy the material world is not being given, so you become angry. And you think the world is useless, so you become, you have despair or hopelessness, because you think there is no meaning to life.
这两种情绪，是一个是当享受物质世界的这种欲望遭到了挫折之后，他就会愤怒是生气，这跟 karma 跟欲望物质欲望相关。而另外一种呢，绝望是对物质世界的排斥和拒绝，这就是跟 jnana 相关的。他就当一个人这种处在这种绝望情绪当中，他就觉得物质世界是没有用的， 活着也没有意义。
So both of these philosophies are rejected by, both of these philosophies are rejected, they're not compatible with devotional service.
这两种哲学和奉献服务都是不和谐，就不符合奉拜服务的这种范畴。The next one?
Yeah.
Hare Krishna.
Krishna.
Lord, 那个 Yogita Dharma 一直在举手，他可以开麦吗？是不是有问题？
Yogita Sharma has been raising his or her hand for a long time. Can he or she open unmute?
She cannot type her question. Have we got any other questions first?
Okay, Ina said that I apologize for the difficulty with the translation, but fortunately,Because of this difficulty, we receive so much important information from Buddha, Jesus, and Humble Basins, their devotees. Okay. 下一个问题是来自于 Chaitanya Charan. Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Gurudev 奉献者 Brahma 希望服务 Vrindavas, Brajavasi, 大部分人都很乐意服务纯粹奉献者、高级奉献者，服务一般奉献者可能就没那么乐意，甚至没办法和一般奉献者友好相处。这对修习 Krishna 之间有意义吗？怎么改正这种状态呢？Chaitanya Charan Prabhu said, Hare Krishna, business Guru and all devotees, Lord Brahma want to serve Rajabhas very much. Most people, want to serve pure devotee or senior devotee, advanced devotee, but are not so obliged, so willing to serve ordinary devotee, even cannot get along with ordinary devotee. So is that beneficial to practice Krishna consciousness, and how to correct this condition?
Well, they have to become more humble, and they have to become more tolerant, and they have to learn how to serve ordinary devotees. They cannot expect to serve the pure devotees if they cannot work with ordinary devotees.
他们要学习怎么变得谦卑，变得容忍，学习怎么去服务普通奉献者。如果连普通奉献者都不能友好相处，又怎么能指望去服务纯粹奉献者呢？
In other words, you have to start from the bottom and work up.
换句话说，就是要从基层开始，来处理好基层关系，然后再从基层关系再往上处理好更高的关系。
So certainly not good if somebody's not able to get along with devotees, if they don't have good relationships with devotees, they cannot work together. This is not good. This is the material world. This is the influence of Kali Yuga, where we quarrel and we fight with each other. We're allowing Kali Yuga to enter into our midst.
就是不能处理好跟普通奉献者的关系，这是由于卡里年代的影响，就是有争吵、纷争和虚伪，然后这是允许卡里就进入到我们的队伍当中了。
So we have to try to keep Kali out. We have to keep Kali out. We have to take shelter of Lord Krishna in devotional service. And devotional service requires us to be meek and humble. So it's important for us all to learn humility in the service of Krishna.
满怀着全部的谦卑之情来服务主 Krishna。
Okay, go ahead.
下一个问题。
Hare Krishna, 前面还有两个, 我念一下。
好的，谢谢。
陈娟的问题。 顶拜部队和所有奉献者, 我们的服务心态, 要追随文达文的居民和牧牛姑娘的服务心态吗? 用所有一切都用来取悦Krishna吗? 可以向Krishna祈祷吗?
This question is from Chen Jun. Are we supported? So should our mood of service be like that the mood of Gopi and the mood of Vrindavan? And use everything to please Krishna. Should we pray like this?
Well, I don't know. I don't think you'd want to preach like this in the beginning. I think this is something you have to work up to.
She said, can she pray like this?
Or can she pray?
Yeah, pray.
Yes, you can pray like that, but you have to be worthy of that. You know, you have to consider what is your own position, what is your qualification. We have to understand the mood of the gopis, the people of Vrindavan. They're the highest, they're on the topmost level of pure devotion. So, what is your position in devotional service? How long have you been a devotee? What is your own ability to follow in the mood of the gopis?
在追随那些牧牛姑娘的心态这条路上，您自己的能力，您是有什么样的能力呢？
Have you got detached from the material body?
您有没有已经弃绝了对物质躯体的依恋呢？
Have you given up sense gratification?
您有没有已经放弃了感官享乐呢？
We have to think about these things, you know. Then you can think if you're able to actually transcend the material nature, then you can think about the mood of the gopis. So you have to be guided by your spiritual master.
Hence, you need to receive the spiritual master's guidance.
It might be better for you to study very carefully the Bhagavad Gita before you try to become like the gopis.
所以您最好是去好好的研习一下国家梵歌，然后再考虑去追随木牛姑娘的心态。
Bhagavad Gita brings us up to the position of surrender to Krishna.
国家梵歌就能将我们提升到臣服 Krishna 的地位上。
Then once we've surrendered to Krishna, then we can think about the mood of the gopis.
一旦我们臣服了 Krishna 之后，我们就可以考虑一下追随木牛姑娘的心态了。
So I have to understand the mood of the gopis is something very special, very exalted, and you know we may not be ready for that yet.
要知道木牛姑娘的心态是非常特殊的心态，而且是非常崇高的一种心态。我们可能还到此为止还没有做好准备。
May take us, we may need to have more time before we're ready to take up the mood of the gopis.
在我们准备好接受木牛姑娘的心态之前，我们还需要花一些时间。可能我们现在还没到的时候。
But you can pray like that.
但是您可以去祈祷，像这样去祈祷。
We do pray. Lord Chaitanya has given us prayers like that in the Shikshastikam.
主柴丹尼亚在主的八训规当中就给出世人一些就是祈祷，怎样去祈祷。
So you can pray to always be.Follower of the footsteps of the gopis.
You can 祈祷去总是追随木牛姑娘的步伐
And gradually one day, you can enter more into that mood of the gopis.
逐渐的到某一天，您可以真正的去进入到这木牛姑娘的心绪的。
So we have the Krishna book, you can read the Krishna book, you can read about the gopis there and you can understand more about the mood of the gopis. Okay, yeah.
Hare Krishna, 顶拜 Guru Maharaj Raja, 顶拜所有奉献者，请问如何才能感到灵修的紧迫感？如何才能努力在这一次回归灵性世界 ？Hare Krishna.
Krishna, based on the Buddha and all devotees, how can I feel the urgency of spiritual practice, and how can I?Make endeavor that I can go back to Godhead in this very lifetime.
Okay, yes, it's good. You're thinking we should feel urgency about this life. We should feel the urgency to become Krishna conscious.
非常好，您能够感受到这个生命的紧迫和短暂，感受到 Krishna 知觉的重要性。
We have to understand.How valuable time is, and how one moment lost can never be bought back.
We 们要明白，时间是多么的宝贵，一分一秒的失去都无法挽回的损失。
We have limited time in the material world.
我们在物质世界的时间是多么的有限。
We do not know how long we have left.Before we have to give up this body. There are so many horrible things in the material world.
物 这世界有这么多令人 可怕的恐怖的事件发生。
Sometimes there's horrible accidents, maybe road accidents, and people are killed.
有时候就有意外事件发生，比如说在车祸中丧生。
Sometimes people throw bombs or drop bombs on other people and were killed in that way.
有的时候就有恐怖分子向人群当中投放炸弹，然后使人们死于这个事件。
And sometimes there's terrible viruses like COVID, or there's also things like cancer.
有的时候就是有像病毒流行，就像现在的这个新冠病毒的流行，还有这癌症这种疾病。
So there's so many ways in which we can, our life can be got, taken from us very quickly, any of these different ways.
所以一个人的生命，人的生命可以以这种种种的方式被很快的夺走。
So we have to understand material world is temporary and our time is limited.
我们要明白物质世界是短暂的，而我们的生命是那么有限。
I saw some of my godbrothers. We saw just last year we lost His Holiness Bhakti Charuswami, a very senior devotee. He got the COVID and he died within a week.
我的神兄弟，不是说他的神兄弟巴提查鲁斯瓦米，就是一个非常年长资深的，巴什纳瓦，他去年就在一周之内就是死于新冠病毒。
And then this year, just a month or more ago, we lost one very nice devotee who had been serving the deities here, serving Lord Nrisingadev, Pankajangari Prabhu. He also got disease and he also died very quickly, in a week.
就在马普，就在今年一个月之前，被非常美妙的，服务主你身上那个神像的Pankajangari Prabhu，他也是在因为患了新冠病毒，就在一周之内就非常快的就离开了躯体。
So we see examples of people leaving the world. We didn't expect them to go, but suddenly they're taken from us.
所以这种种的例子就表明人们都在离开这个世界，根本就是没有事先想到，而突然之间就发生了。
So we have to be ready that very soon our turn will be coming also.
所以我们应当做好准备，很快就会轮到我们自个儿。
We all have to leave the world soon.
我们所有的人都会很快地离开这个世界。
So we have to make the best use of every moment given to us in this world.
所以我们应当最佳地去利用，给予我们在这个世界上给予我们的这些片片刻刻的时光。
So we should feel very conscious about every moment. Don't waste time.
所以我们对每分每秒都要非常有知觉、有意识，千万不要浪费光阴。
Right, we say in China, it's very easy to buy an inch of gold, but you cannot buy one inch of time.
中文有句话叫一寸光阴一寸金，寸金难买寸光阴。
And we say also time moves like an arrow. It's very fast.
还有一句话叫做就时光如梭如如 如箭一般的流逝，很快的就飞逝而过。
光阴时间。
光阴时间。
So must be very careful. And that's the first part of the question. The second part was how to go back to Godhead.
How to be sure that we can endeavor that in this very lifetime we can go back.
Well, we have to be fully. We have to be.Very seriously engaged in our devotional service. Krishna says, as you surrender to me, I reward you accordingly.
Krishna 说，我根据一个人对我的皈依程度给予相应的回报。
So we have to take full shelter of Lord Krishna, and then we're safe.
We must completely surrender Krishna, then we will be safe.
And Krishna has given his guarantee. Krishna said, "My devotee will never perish." So we have to have faith in Krishna's words.
Krishna 做出了保证，我的奉献者永不毁灭，所以我们要对 Krishna 的话语满怀信心。
A devotee is surrendered to Krishna. If Krishna wants us to go back to Godhead, Krishna will take us. If Krishna wants us to stay in the material world, devotee also is willing to stay. He'll do whatever Krishna wants.
因为奉献者是臣服了的灵魂，所以会去做按照 Krishna 的想法意愿去做事。如果 Krishna 想要奉献者回归的话，奉献者就回归；如果 Krishna 希望奉献者留下来的话，那么奉献者也会留下来。
So we don't.We just have to put ourselves under Krishna's shelter and fully engage in his service and then leave everything else up to Krishna. So long, a devotee is happy just to be engaged in Krishna's service, wherever he may go. Hell becomes heaven if Krishna is there. But if you go to heaven and there's no Krishna, it will become hell. So we have to take shelter of Lord Krishna.
所以我们要托庇于主 Krishna.
Okay.
还有问题
Yeah. Okay, Yogita Sharma is there with her hand up still.
那 Yogita Sharma 他仍然是不是在举手呢？
对，他说这个很难用文字来表述。
他可以说话，给他机会。
可以说话。
好的。
Yogita Shama, 您可以说开麦说话，不如说。
Thank you, Mataji. Hare Krishna Gurudev. Sorry to bother you, Gurudev. I didn't, I typed the question, but it didn't make sense to me. I was confused. Gurudev, Lord Shiva, because I'm preaching to also some Shivas.
What? Yes, I'm not hearing you clearly. Speak up. Lord Shiva?
Lord Shiva had a fight with Lord Krishna. And Lord Rama's avatar, Lord Ram prayed to Lord Shiva. So they're asking, which one is Lord Shiva's favorite? Because I'm also wondering, because it should be Lord Krishna, right? Because Lord Shiva would know that Lord Krishna is the supreme personality of Godhead, as he is the expansion of the Lord. I mean, that is what I was a bit confused about, Gurudev, so I didn't want to answer that question, so I thought I'll ask you, which...
Lord Shiva, he's a devotee of Krishna, but at the same time he worships Lord Rama.
Yeah, and Lord Rama worshipped him when Lord Rama had come down on earth. That time he prayed to Lord Shiva, and accordingly they said Lord Shiva is very pleased with him. And Lord Rama is said to be Lord Shiva's favorite. And I didn't know how to answer that. I said, all I know is that Lord Krishna, because Lord Shiva also took part as one of the gopis. So Lord Shiva wouldn't make a difference like that, but I said I would get back to you which one is actually the favorite. I mean, I didn't know how to answer it really.
Which one is the favorite of Lord Shiva?
Yeah.
Did you get it, Guru Mani?
Lord Shiva fight Krishna and Rama. Lord Rama worship Shiva. And she's confused though, which one is the favorite, Lord Rama or Krishna, right?
Yeah.
No. 就是他就问这个奉献者说，就是主 Shiva， 他曾经和主 Krishna 作战。然后当主 Ramachandra 他降临地球的时候呢，他曾经崇拜了主 Shiva， 所以，这个奉献他不理解，他有点困惑，不知道主 Shiva 最喜欢 Rama 还是最喜欢 Krishna。
Well, he likes both Rama and Krishna. They're both God. You don't have to make a distinction.
但是主 Shiva 两个都喜欢，因为他们都是神，所以不需要去做区分。
Lord Rama, he worshipped Lord Shiva before he went to Lanka, and Prabhupada explained, he said, that was...
主 Rama 在去兰卡，进攻兰卡之前，他首先崇拜了主 Shiva。圣帕帕德说，主 Rama 他这么去做，是为了，意图是为了告知主 Shiva， 他要去杀死Shiva 的奉献者。
And we see also Lord Shiva fighting against Lord Krishna because Lord Shiva had given a benediction to his devotee, one of Lord Shiva's devotees named Banasura. Yeah.
主 Shiva 跟主 Krishna 作战是因为主 Krishna 和主 Shiva 的一个奉献者叫 Banasura 魔，跟 Banasura 魔打仗。
So that Banasura, he had many arms, and he'd become very proud. So Lord Krishna cut off his arms and left him with just four.
Banasura 魔他有很多臂膀，然后他就为此感到很骄傲，不可一世。主 Krishna 于是便把他的这些多余的臂膀都砍掉了，只给他剩下了四条臂膀。
And Lord Shiva gave the benediction to that Banasura that he would stay with Lord Shiva and be one of his eternal associates. So Lord Shiva said that was his, when he's fighting against Lord Krishna, he said that was his ignorance, that he was so, you know, he was so much obliged to his own devotee Banasura that it came that he ended up fighting against Lord Krishna. But you can read in the Srimad Bhagavatam, the fourth canto, there's the song of Lord Shiva, where Lord Shiva is worshipping the Supreme Lord, Krishna. So Lord Shiva offers his respects to both Lord Rama and Lord Krishna.
既尊敬 Rama, 又尊敬 Krishna.
Lord Rama is the expansion of Lord Krishna. Lord Rama is worshipped in the mood of Aishwarya. Lord Rama is a king, so there's no intimacy there with Lord Rama. But with Krishna, there's more intimacy. So actually Lord Shiva is the devotee of Sankarshan. Sankarshan is the expansion of Balaram, and Lord Shiva is his worshipable deity is actually Lord Sankarshan. And the snakes which Lord Shiva has on his body, they are the representation of Lord Sankarshan. And we see Lord Shiva, that he takes the water of the Ganges on his hair. His hair is always wet with the water of the Ganges. So that water of the Ganges, that is the Abhishek, that water is washed the lotus feet of Krishna, and Lord Shiva takes it on his head. So you see Lord Shiva. You can see Lord Shiva respecting how he has great respect for Lord Krishna. At the same time, Lord Shiva also told his wife in the Vishnu Sahasranam, Lord Shiva told his wife that she didn't need to chant all the names of Lord Vishnu, she just needed to chant the name of Lord Ram, that the 1,000 names of Vishnu is equal to one's chanting the holy name of Lord Ram. So in this way, Lord Shiva also told his wife to chant the name of Lord Rama.
Thank you so very much. Very clearly understood. Thank you, Gurudev.
Okay.
We'll be able to answer now. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Okay, no more questions. Krishna Kumar.
Yeah.
Hi, Yuvanti.
Yo, yes.
Oh,
I
have four questions. Jishu, got Jishu, okay.
OK, 那我们继续来回答。
你有
下一个
时间 ，Guru Mani， 你可以吗？你有
？Yes, I have. 我有时间 ，Yes.
OK, go ahead.
下一个八个题，顶拜 Guru， 说奉献行为 Guru， 一以下几个词什么意思 ？Krishna, Dharma, Kaurava, Bharatvarsha 是什么意思？八个题 ask what's the meaning of the term Krishna Dharma。Kaurava, Bharatvarsha. Varsha, what's the meaning of Varsha?
Varsha. Varsha means land.
Varsha 的意思是土地。
Right, it's around, it means the borders are land. If it's a dweep, then it's an island. But a Varsha means it's surrounded by land.
Okay. 如果就是是 dweep, dweep 这个词就是它是一个岛。但如果是 Varsha 的意思是它的周围它的边疆以外仍然是陆地就所以称为 Varsha、
So Bharatvarsha, the land of Bharat
Bharatvarsha 的意思就是 Bharat 之地、
And the other word was Krishna Dharma?
Yes.
What's the meaning of Krishna Dharma?Well,、
yes.
Dharma can mean many things. Dharma means, it can mean like the nature of something. Just like the nature of salt is, or the nature of sugar is sweet and the nature of chili is hot. So Dharma represents the nature of the living entity. The nature of the living entity is service, that we should be engaged in service.That dharma means service to the supreme lord. So Krishna
dharma,
Krishna dharma, service to Krishna.
Krishna dharma 的意思就是对 Krishna 的服务。Dharma 这个词有很多意思，它的意思本意就是一件事物的本性，比如说。盐的本性是甜的，糖的本性是甜的，辣椒的本性是辣的，所以生物的本性就是服务，那生物的就应当服务至尊主，所以 Krishna Dharma 的意思就是对 Krishna 的服务。
Yeah, 下一个问题。
Kaurava.
Kaurava.
Yeah.
What's the meaning of Kaurava?
Yes.
Kaurava means the people born in the Kuru dynasty. The Kurus, the Pandavas are also born in the Kuru dynasty. And so it's the name of the family, the great, you know, from a great king. And they're all born in that line.
Kaurava 就是，它是一个家族的名称，就是这个意思，就是库鲁王朝的人们被称为 Kaurava， 这是来自一个伟大的国王库鲁王，所以他的后裔就被称为 Kaurava。
Yeah, actually the Pandavas are also Kauravas, but Dhritarashtra separated them and he called his sons the Kaurava, and the Pandavas, they're just known the Pandavas, but they're actually all Kauravas, they're all in the same family.
So she's this devotee is asking about the purport of the verse Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 1, Chapter 4, verse 32. It says that the service, pure devotional service to the Supreme Lord is called Bhagavata Dharma. But those monists do not have the chance to enter into this realm. And the monists are not categorized as the Paramahansa. Those who are situated in the perfect stage of renunciation. So I do not understand this. What does it mean of this term, monists? So can you explain it?
Monists means people like Mayavadis. They don't recognize that there are two souls in the body. They think everyone is, you know, there's only one soul and that we're all the Supreme, we're all God. So that's a monist. What else did she want to know?
That's all. She only caught the purport.
She just wanted to know what the monist means. The monist is not the monist is not counted amongst the Paramahamsas. Paramahamsas mean the great souls, those who are completely detached from the material world.
Yes.
Uh-huh. So monists, the monists, they're Mayavadis. They don't do devotional service. They simply think of the Brahman. Their goal is impersonal liberation, merging with the oneness. They don't do devotional service. Okay, yeah. 下一个问题,
Huawei 有时很激情, 然后意识到控制心, 然后意识到要控制心, 那么这个过程半神是如何控制的? Sometimes I feel very passionate, but afterwards I realize I have to control my mind. So during this progress, during this period, so how does the demigod control? So how the demigod control us during the course that we We have to control our mind after we felt very compassionate, very passionate.
Well, the problem is we're influenced by the modes of nature.
问题是我们受到物质自然属性的影响。
It's the modes of nature which are influencing us more than the demigods.
就物质自然属性对我们的影响，是超过了半神人们对我们的影响了。
So you're going to control your mind. We have to know, understand the mind and the nature of the mind, and we have to come up. How do we control the mind? We control the mind by good intelligence, and we get good intelligence from the soul.
如何控制心意呢？就是我们需要了解心意，了解心的本性。我们要知道，就是心意是受到智性控制的，而智性又受到灵魂的控制。
So we have to keep our mind strong by fixing the mind on Krishna.
我们要让心意变得稳定强大。如何稳定心意呢？就让它专注于 Krishna.
So you have to chant. You have to chant and remember Krishna. Think about Krishna's pastimes and describe Krishna's qualities.
专注于Krishna呢，就是通过念诵，就要记住Krishna，记住Krishna的消失光，Krishna的品质。
Should be eager always to speak about Krishna.
应该渴望总是描述Krishna。
Okay, 下一个问题。
下一个是Bhakti，全神贯注于Krishna，手持笛子的形象，不能转移其他形象。 We have to concentrate wholeheartedly on the original form of Krishna, who has the on his hand the vena on Krishna's hand, and this is the original form. But in Kali Yuga, everybody should worship Gaurinitai. How to understand that? And we shouldn't transfer our mind on the other form of Krishna, but at the same time, in Kali Yuga, we all worship Gaurinitai. So how to understand?
Well, we worship Gaurinitai, and Gaurinitai will bring us to worship Krishna.
我们崇拜Gaurinitai，但是Gaurinitai会
Lord Chaitanya and Lord Nityananda, they're always thinking of Krishna. And so we think of Gaurinitai, and they will help us to think of Krishna. Hayawantima.
That's all.
Okay, so we'll stop here. Oh, woman.
As far as I know, that's all. Shiva Krishna Kumar, Adachi. Yes, that's all.
Woman Ganshiya Guru Mani Gi Woman Gentai Defani Ganshiya Krishna Kumari Jujur Ganshiya Soy Defang Shenzhen Ling Ting Tiwan Jufu Niman Shanghua Kwai La Jintan Shri Ekadasi Sai Jili, Bujadam Naben Yashri Ekadasi Ma?
Shiva.
Okay, so I mean, Jintan Do Nin Song, Bunang Chi Ugu, Do Shang Krishna, Chinao Krishna. Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki.
Jai.
Jai. Gaur Bhakta
Vrinda Ki. Jai.